Welcome back in PHP Excel tutorial series. In this chapter, I will demonstrate and explain how to populate Excel sheet with data from mysql database. This chapter also covers cells merging, simple styling, aligning, dimensions and basic bordering. Let's start. Assuming that we already have a table which contains some data. In this example, a list of clients. As a side note, instead of PHPExcel, you can use PHPSpreadsheet which have more file type supports. Of course, you can use PHPSpreadsheet with this tutorial because both of them have little differences. I just reuse the code from previous chapter to make things easier. First thing first, we need to open a connection to database. You can use PDO class, MySQLi, or now deprecated MySQL functions to work with databases. Here I use MySQLi to keep it simple. Then create a database select query to get the list of clients. Before we loop through the query result, we need to define starting row number to display our data. Here I reserve 3 rows to put titles and table heading, so I start putting data from 4th row. Next, make a loop to put the records into cells while incrementing the row number in every iteration. Here we hard-coded the column and use incrementing variable for the row. If generated Excel file cannot be opened, it means there is an error thrown by PHP. Let's correct that. We did it, but it doesn't look good because the data is longer than the cell width, so let's correct that. By using getColumnDimension, we can change the specified cell's width by using setWidth method. So far so good, now let's add title and column heading so it looks more like a table. Then merge the title cell to make it looks neat. Use range name as a parameter in merge cells function. Now, here is a basic cell styling. The styles is defined in an array manner, which we'll explain more in the next chapter. For now, we just need to tinker with font and borders. Good, now let's adjust the title's alignment and give borders to data. We'll be right back. Here are some border options available in Excel. Here I use outline options for the data. Now our table looks like what table is supposed to looks like. This concludes this chapter of tutorial. See you in the next chapter.